So if these are not active, what's going to happen? You're going to wind up lots of this as you're calling on this to be active, because this is not active, then you wind up looking like a question mark.
Okay.
We don't want that. Ah, very good. Oh, you just grew, like the Grinch, you just grew 3 inches that day. Okay.
She has a heck of a voice. She has a wonderful voice. Oh, I'm hearing you just too much of the pronunciation, too much F. And I just.
He's saying he wants more space, less emphasis.
We
on
know what you're saying.
Okay.
If we haven't understood it by then, we're.
Well, okay, go. Just give it one more time and go to that place that I told you that sounds to your ear like noise.
Okay.
Sounds to your ear like, ugh. Ugh. Really? Yeah.
Yeah. What should we start?
Let's go into
the song. And I could stand a little bit more from Junko, a bit more back bass in this, at the descending part.
Yeah.
So talked about in our lesson.
Putting right in that mask.
And right when I did that, it was like, I could feel the laser.
There you go. The laser. The key to that is leaving space open and not jamming it, but allowing it. You have here a fabulous what do they call it? In-law suite to your house that you just discovered. Imagine you had this whole house and you said, oh, there's a whole new room, a wing over here with its own kitchenette and everything. Oh my heavens, it should be that sort of thing. Oh my heavens, there's a lot more space than I've been constraining myself to. And then allow, like sometimes you use the image of a ballroom and you open the ballroom and you allow your guests to come in. You don't push them through the door. You make it encouraging. But now, I think this whole thing is going to work more when you have an emotional investment. Right now, you're just
trying to line
things up. I think with Junko as well, there doesn't seem to be a why or wherefore of why it's doing what it's doing.
And a constant building throughout this particular arrangement, which is very obvious.
And when we don't have that, then it's not working on its own. It's not like it just naturally.
Because this one is quite straightforward, building from a quiet place to a real climactic moment where some of the other arrangements are kind of going back and forth through emotions and then boom.
Well, you remember, what book of the Bible is this from? The most powerful book of the Bible. It's the book that you're least likely to approach lightly. The book of the it's about the apocalypse. It's about the end of the world. Yeah, it is that vision. So it is not a pretty, won't that be pretty? Mm-mm. Especially not in this arrangement. You really hear it. You hear the
kind of the symphonic stuff coming from the piano.
Exactly.
Sometimes we're not lined up yet.
Because
we only did it once.
Okay. So then we'll come back.
It's a really wonky situation where pianists don't come into lessons. This is the first time I get to hear them with piano.
Oh, yeah, you've never even heard this one.
And so I can't do the little tuning in my Will you please tell them the value of having a pianist in your lesson?
It's very important.
It's super important.
They'll be there next week.
Yep. All right. All right. Good, guys.